Reborn Susie here from Minnesota, and I garden in a zone 4B, and I'm taking you on a tour of my sun and part sun containers. I would say this gets about part sun here, and it's just, but it gets a lot of afternoon sun. Is that just not beautiful? It's the start of July, and they just look fantastic. This is a seed I started, Celine Sabella Carmine. I just love it. The birds have been playing in it a little bit. That's why it's a little more, but it, you know what? It looks fantastic. And actually, I do have Dichondra Silver Falls, which is getting taken over, but look at it with the shrub behind it blooming. Oh, love it. I might have to come at some point and give it a haircut. And here, this is growing a lot. But the blooming has been very little. I do have slow release fertilizer in all my containers. I might have to come by with this one, but the heat could have probably done a number on it. There are buds in there forming. It's an alyssum. And then back, I just have some of my perennial seedlings. This is Calamintha Marvelet White, and it looks really good in there. I think I water it once a week. And it just keeps performing. And I have not deadheaded. I did put some of my perennial seedlings also in this container here. It's an obedient plant I started, and only reason is because they were all getting bloom stalks. I wanted to see what they look like, and they're gonna stay in here. I'll see if I can get them to overwinter in this. I've just been running out of space in my garden, so. Look at that one with the grass. Oh, love that. I'm really into pelargoniums this year. This is a regal pelargonium. If there's any names of the plants you want, just let me know in the comments down below. Otherwise, this could take a bit long, and I gotta keep them a little bit shorter. I'm using my phone to film. I just need to get a new memory card. Oh, I love this. This just, I wasn't sure how it was gonna do. It was just taking its sweet time, and the bees love it. Look at that with that backdrop. Oh, I'm very happy I gave that one a chance. It looked tough when I planted it. But a lot of my seedlings didn't. They were in the cans a little too long. I did buy the Senecio. I just absolutely love this. This is part of my moon flower garden, along with the Calamintha, which is just doing so good. I do have some Dusty Miller back there. Probably not needed. It will get bigger though. Again, this, one thing I find about pelargoniums is just don't treat them nicely. I've kind of been letting them dry out between waterings and just kind of deadheading. Most are looking good. There's one that's taken a little bit. Scaevola, love that. I don't pinch that or prune that. And this is a Datura I started from seed. I just have to like keep an eye on it. This is tends to be prone to bug issues. Sometimes when I see ants, it's a good indication that maybe there's an aphid issue. This was beautiful yesterday. It was a little more white, but it's Datura ballerina white. This one is a heavy feeder. I might have to give that a little more fertilizer because you can definitely see the size of these. I mean, they're massive, poisonous. I just recently added this because I didn't know where to put the juga, but I do like it in this basket. It's working, and it is pushing out some really pretty growth there. And the back here is just butterfly bush that I started from seed. There are blooms forming. This is also one where it does better with neglect. This one has been yellowing a little bit. we'll see. I mean, it is kind of getting shaded out by this big rose here, which, but this blue is unbelievable. I might come in and just, again, also give it a good haircut. This plant just glows. And then here, the rose fell on that, so I did prop it up down there. But this is bee balm, bergamot or bergamot. Look at that. I know they say you can use this in cut flower arrangement. Look at the tears on this. Is that not just, it's a seed I started. I love it. It is a little weak though, the stems, so it may not hold up to a storm, which would be a shame because it's just getting going. This is my 4th of July container. It's July 3rd, so I do want to wish everyone an early 4th of July, or happy 4th of July. This is doing exactly what I wanted it to do. This is Orlea. The seed I started, I was a little worried when this was part of my winter sowing. I only had 3 that worked. And that says it doesn't transplant well, and you know what? Yeah, it did. It was, oh, look at that. I do have to deadhead, otherwise it will go to seed. That's the only downside. And then Fairy Queen Salvia is my blue. And then this is my red, kind of my red version of it. Purple Prince Alternathera. Look at that. It's what I envisioned in my head, and the fact that it turned out the way I had, it's just amazing. And then this one right here looks so tough when I planted them because they were all intertwined and I had to rip them out, and I think I defoliated 75% of the plant. This is just a bit vigorous. I wasn't expecting it to be that strong of a grower, and it's gonna be loaded in buds. It's the start of it down here. So far I'm just seeing purple. It's a mix, but they last forever. Is that not beautiful? Look at that. Can't wait till this is just covered in that. I wasn't even gonna plant them because they look so tough. I would say it took them about a month. I love this area over here. 90% are either cuttings of mine, like coleus cuttings, or seeds I started. Joey Lambstail is amazing. Lasts forever. The penstemon is just starting back there. Happy I gave that a chance. The black-eyed Susan vine took forever, but that was put through the ringer. But the foliage this year and the vines are much tougher. And what can I say about this coleus? This is where I think I'm gonna have to pinch it, otherwise it's gonna flop and squish everything around it. The agastache, I think it's lavender hyssop. Put on its first flush of blooms, now it's going through. I thought it would be a bit taller, but it's going to, because when you look at that. So I've been kind of deadheading. I did plant up some more of my dahlia seedlings. Only reason, because there's one over here that's spectacular. So I want to see how these perform. This grass here, it's okay. But it is putting out more foliage, which again, it's taken a bit for that. More of the regal pelargoniums. Look. And I love the Purple Prince Alternathera. It's just, and the Limon Talonum. That's amazing. I think this is Profusion Apricot Zinnia, and one I started from seed, loving it. See how beautiful that is? I think on its own, it's amazing because it just kind of brings out the colors of everything. This is the one where it's lagging a little bit because it's been yellowing. I backed off the watering, but I've got all this new growth here. Yeah, castor oil bean. I think it's New Zealand purple. Also poisonous. Love it in this area. But look, this is my dahlia I started from seed. And this is why. Oh, look. And it's covered in buds and blooms, and I keep deadheading. I need to deadhead this one. Love that one. And then Kufia honeybells. That one I bought. I didn't start that one from seed. This one, I just cut all of it, but look at, there's so many to come. My snapdragons didn't make it, so I replaced it with these zinnias. Aren't they beautiful? And then this, I mean, look at the combination with this, this, and this one. This is definitely a very vibrant area, and I'm loving it. All right, it is sprinkling, so I'm just gonna kinda wrap this up a little quick. This pelargonium I'm excelling at. I don't know what it is that I'm doing with this one, but it's loaded. Again, I'm loving the Dusty Miller. Just, it's a seed I started, and just a vinca here. And the eucalyptus, oh my goodness, is this amazing. I just love to touch this. I don't know what it, oh, love that. And the smell, what can I say about that? But I like how this kind of works with the front of my house, just kind of pulls those colors. So yeah. Really, really liking this. That's why I'm having lots of fun with containers this year. There's just been a little watering, a little deadheading. Like I said, no fertilizing so far with a slow release. Like, I might have to come in here and pinch, that's for sure. This one's just becoming a beast over here. And yeah, and I have my hose out all the time. I love to water. I just need to kind of pick and choose. Like I said, I kind of do all of them where this is pretty dry, but when I get in there, there's still some moisture in there. So I'm just trying to back off on the pelargoniums, but this dahlia here requires watering every day. But oh, look at that. At some point, if I start seeing my plants kind of yellowing or just kind of stop blooming or just lagging a little bit, then I might go in. So hopefully enjoyed, and bye for now.